Hello, Patrick Walchuk here, and welcome to our first real estate movie of 2023. And again, if you enjoy getting these things, click on the subscription button, hit the notification bell, and we'll send them out to you. So we're going to be looking at January of 2023, comparing it to January of 2022. And for those of you who are the faint-hearted, you may not want to watch this because it's going to be ugly. And what you have to put into perspective is that last January, February, and March were the hottest real estate months of the year when everything was in a mad frenzy. So of course everything's going to be looking bad this year. So let's get right into it. For residential properties, anything other than a freehold, there were 310 properties that traded hands, and that's a decrease of about 27%. The average price of those properties was about $716,000. That's a decline of 16%. The number of active listings is closing in on 1,900, and that's more than triple what we had last year at only about 600. And in terms of how long it's taking to sell, basically it's taking, you know, almost three times as long as it did last January in only 40 days. So you can see how fast things are moving last year. Now, what happened in the world of condos in January? Story is pretty much the same. We had 142 of them sell, and that's a decrease of 47%. The average price of a condo is about 413, a decline of 8.5. The active listings, you know, that skyrocketed up to 477 from 225. And in terms of days on the market, that's doubled from last January at 47 days. And that was January to January. Now, again, what we started doing last year is want to show you how things look from the previous month. So compared to December of 2022, the price in January of 2023 is basically flat. So the bleeding has stopped and we seem to be stabilizing in prices.